ladies and gentlemen, my name is Paul Heyman. Now, in case you're not watching your own show, Mr. SmackDown executive, your tribal chief, Roman Reigns, and I just arrived. We haven't had a chance to submit this contract to an attorney, let alone even the wise man getting his eye. The wise man getting his eyes on that agreement. So therefore, unfortunately, Roman Reigns will not sign that contract this evening.
Just so we're clear, Roman Reigns isn't signing this contract. Paul, that's absolutely fine. Because I have three signatures here from the willing participants, and I'll simply make this a triple threat match for the vacant, undisputed WWE Universal Heavyweight Championship.
I don't know if you realize this, but Mr. Aldis, I care deeply about you, sir. Sorry. I do. I halfway respect and admire the mediocre job that you've done as the SmackDown executive in charge of the show, and the fact that you do such a mediocre job like so many other people back there, but while doing it, you look really good at it, especially in these Paul Heyman wannabe custom suits that you've been wearing. But no matter how good you look, there's no way you can sell this to the board of directors, no way you can sell this to the fine, upstanding people of Atlanta, Georgia? And no way you can sell it to your tribal chief who does call the shots here in WWE, because the tribal chief, Roman Reigns, should be defending the title at the Royal Rumble in a one-on-one match. I don't care.
Will you shut the hell up? You're right about one thing. This should be a one-on-one match. I had Roman Reigns' shoulders pinned at Crown Jewel, and his cross-eyed half-wit cousins saved him. But Paul, you speak one more word, I'll come over there and I'll cut bacon off your back. This should be my rematch, but instead, a couple Johnny-come-latelys walk up. You got AJ, you got Randy. All of a sudden, they get to jump to the front of the line and be a part of the match that should be mine after having a few months off.
A few months off?
Yeah.
Maybe you don't get it. You see, the Bloodline tried to end my career, and you walked over my dead body to get that match with Roman Reigns. And you lost. So you're lucky to be even in this match.
Luck. You've got to be talking about the wrong guy. If there's anybody with a horseshoe planted firmly up his keister, it's got to be you. I'll put it to you like this. You should really watch the bass in your voice when you're talking to me, and maybe go ahead and turn all your attention to Roman Reigns.
Oh, that's real good, genius. You understand that we're not just fighting Roman Reigns. We're fighting each other. Get that through your thick skull.
Oh, that's how it works. Thank you for that. I'm glad you explained it to me, because here's exactly how it works. I walk in, I pin Roman Reigns, I become WWE champion. If that means I have to walk over your dead body again, I will do it. The only difference being, it won't be the bloodline that leaves your land. It'll be the man with everybody saying,
AJ Styles has decked LA Knight and Knight answering. The animosity between these two, there for all to see. Styles and Knight throwing haymakers at one another. Need to get some security out there. Nick Aldis is breaking them up personally.
That's the SmackDown GM in the middle. Here comes
the more WWE officials pouring out of the backstage area, trying to keep Knight and Styles away from one another.
This is nasty. Between the man they call the megastar and AJ Styles.
Oh! Styles trying to get some more, and LA Knight happy to oblige. Much to the delight of the wise man.
I see what you're trying to do, Paul, and it's not going to work, and I'll tell you why it's not going to work. It's not going to work because later tonight I'm going to drop Solo, and I'm going to beat him right in the middle of this very ring, 1, 2, 3. And after I do that, I'm going to reintroduce to Roman Reigns the three most dangerous letters in all of sports entertainment. R.K.